Alright, so here you can see the text box in question in the native original file Quark. And the first thing you'll notice is that you can't click on the lines. And if you view the item, you'll see that it's not locked. You'll see that it's totally forward. And you'll see the content is only text. There are no elements used inside of the box. Okay, so even if I select this, I can't select this line in Quark. I can, if you look over here, move the box a little bit over. Watch what happens when I move the box, text box. Those lines move with it. Okay, so here I can select this line. This line is fine. I can move this line all around. All right. So you see that. So now let's go into InDesign CS5 here. Where is she? There she is. Okay, so here we see if I move some of these palettes out of the way here. You'll see we have the same condition in the converted files, you know, converted with Q2ID version 5, which you're using, and you'll see the same condition. I get the same box. And I can't select any of the lines. Okay, so if I go over into that little line there, once again you can see I can select this line. I could check it in flight check for you here in a second, but effectively Q2ID is converting this file correctly, because you see the that this line is created within the text box. And if we go into... Okay, so just to recap here, these are not lines in the traditional sense as an object. These are lines created under in Quark style formats. Get your paragraph attributes, you go to your rules, and there you can see rule above, rule below. This is a rule below where it indents 2 millimeters from right and adds that line with that style, that width, and that color. That's how you get those lines. They're not objects, but a rule below within the paragraph within this text story. Okay? Just to make that clear. Now let's go back to InDesign. Okay, so here we are with an InDesign, same exact text box, text story, everything selected. I see the same lines. How do I adjust them here in InDesign? Well, it's quite easy, but it is a little bit hidden. It's nowhere in the main menu items here. It's all the way over to the right. So let me take you over there and show you where it is, all the way over in the right on the top of your InDesign menu bar. Here you see the Markzware items, and this is with regards to Q2ID converted this file into InDesign from QuarkXPress, and where or how can I adjust these lines? These lines are not objects, but they're rule below within the paragraph attributes. So now we're going to go over to the right, and I'm going to show you where, all the way over to the right in your screen, how you can adjust that within InDesign. Okay, great. Now we're all the way over in the right here in InDesign. Here's Markzware and the Q2ID, which we just used to convert this customer's test file, this customer's Quark file, right into InDesign. And yeah, how can I get access to these lines? Q2ID did a perfect job. What you notice over here, and this little doohickey thing within the interface of InDesign, we get a whole bunch of options, and if we choose paragraph rules, we get this. So what are we seeing here? Well, we have once again rule below and rule above. Rule above is off, like it should be, so it converted over perfectly. Rule below is on, with a weight of 0.3 points, type of line it is. I mean, we can switch this around to show you how it works, and you see how it instantly changes. So this is how you can adjust the lines and the indent and everything within InDesign. See the right indent once again, 2 millimeters, just like it was within Quark. So Q2ID did a perfect job of converting this file. That's how you can adjust the lines, which are actually paragraph rules, applying a line with a rule below, rule on selected. Well, wait, before I sign off, I do want to let you know that Page Zephyr version 2.11 is now out, and this is a great way for you to have a desktop search on your Macintosh to be able to search within InDesign or Quark files and see all of the content used within those files. So here we see all the files we've indexed on our hard drive, and this desktop search app, this Mac desktop search app, will now allow me to see all of the text stories used within any particular document, like this one here. I can now edit information here, I can delete, I can stylize, and then I can upload to my WordPress blog, my Google Docs, my Scribd account, or my box.net documents. Literally, it's that easy. You can literally convert your content from InDesign, in this case, right in to a WordPress blog or a box.net document. So I just want to give you a little tip. Page Zephyr version 2.11 is out. Check it out. 30-day demo on our webpage. Thank you once again, David Dilling from Markzware, signing off. Have a fantastic day.